he would be handling the last block of your development economics. And then today he would be discussing what are the different investment criteria, development strategy, which covers different investment criteria, the choice of technology, which is very vital, then the role of this cost-benefit analysis while evaluating a project, then the role of planning and regulation, then in maximizing social welfare, further the role of trade that is there for the economic development. So I invite you, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Ashish, and my dear young friends. You know that we are a capital poor country. Capital poor country means, you know that very important economist Noshe. In the last block we have discussed, he told us that there is a vicious circle of poverty, which is the main hindrance for underdevelopment of our country.
तपन सर आपण माइक म्यूट जाई छी सर आपण माइक माइक का म्यूट होई छी
यू आर लिसनिंग
यस सर
ओके एनीवे यू यंग पीपल आर मोर अकस्टम विद टेक्नोलॉजी एंड वी आर पासिंग वी आर इन द पासिंग स्टेज एनीवे our country, you know that it is a very capital poor country. Capital is a very scarce resources in underdeveloped country, and we are engulfed with the problem of the vicious circle of poverty. So because the income is low, the saving is low, the capital formation is low, so investment is low, employment is low, so the production is low, so the income is low. So we are facing a situation, not only we India, almost all the developing country and almost all the undeveloped countries, that we are living in an era where our capital is the main hindrance of economic development. And today our topic of discussion in this block, we shall discuss three different units. In the block 6, the first one, that unit 19, here we shall discuss the allocation of resources and the growth strategies in developing country. Allocation of resources, distribution of resources, particularly, and what are the strategy we have to follow for economic development. Here, our objective is to explain the meaning and importance of investment criteria. As I told you, that because our capital is scarce resources, so proper investment policy or proper investment criteria is utmost important for the underdeveloped country. Similarly, we have to identify the different criteria. What type of criteria is very important, particularly what are the importance and what are the different type of limitations of the investment criteria. And the third and the most important question we shall have to discuss, to appreciate the important problem of the choice of technique. Choice of technique means choosing between the labor intensive technique, capital intensive technique, or the mixed type of technology we have to choose. So here we have to discuss the investment criteria, growth strategy, and particularly that the choice of technology. So let me before going to the topic, so normally that in an underdeveloped country we have two type of strategy we are following. One is called the balanced growth, another is called the unbalanced growth. So let me say, anyone who can say what is balanced growth? Anyone? Balanced growth. Balanced growth means, you know, that simultaneous investment in all the sector of the economy. simultaneous investment in all the sector of the economy. Here, our topic of discussion, suppose the economy has to take the decision. Mean almost all the sector, when investment is made in the primary sector, in the secondary sector, in the tertiary sector, simultaneously in all the sector of the economy, that is otherwise known as balance. Investment in all the sector, it is just like the balanced diet, taking of carbohydrate, protein, vitamin. Similarly, that balanced growth is like balanced diet. Investment in all the sectors simultaneously, in the creation of your social overhead capital as well as the economic overhead capital or directly productivity activities. This is a one strategy. But remember that underdeveloped countries are as such capital poor country, and because they are capital poor country, if we suggest them to invest in all the sectors simultaneously, it is a foolish thing. Shortage of capital is one of the most important problem of underdeveloped country, and if you suggest them invest in all the sector simultaneously, it is just like useless. So another group of economists, Eastman and other, they have given another strategy. They viewed that instead of investing in all the sector, we have to invest in certain selected sector of the economy. Certain selected sector of the economy. For example, suppose you have investment in social overhead capital, mean creation of infrastructure like your electricity, your transport, your communication, then automatically the producer will be interested to invest in other sector, that is the directly productivity activity. So it is not necessary that to invest in all the sectors simultaneously. Rather, we have to invest in selected sector, and the selected sector will create different type of linkage effect of the economy, and this linkage effect will create generate capital in other sector of the economy. So my point of discussion is we have two important strategies. One is that balanced growth means investment in all the sectors simultaneously, and another is unbalanced growth. Unbalancing the economy means creating a disequilibrium. When more and more disequilibrium is created, disequilibrium leads to equilibrium. So this is another important strategy the economists of different time they have suggested. But our topic of discussion today is, so as I told you that because our resources is very scarce, we have to take a proper strategy that what is the question of strategy. So you know that capital, I told you that it is a very very poor part of the economy. In a poor economy, we are facing the shortage of capital, and in such a case, you know that a proper allocation of the capital, this scarce capital, we have to allocate them in such a way that the productivity of the capital should be more. Productivity of the capital should be more, or more and more creation or production or any other thing is possible when more and more investment is made. So here we shall discuss one by one. I shall tell you the different type of strategy that is available. The first one is called social marginal productivity, or SMP criteria. Social marginal productivity, or SMP criteria. You know that this is very, very, very important criteria that were developed by Professor A. E. Khan. So he told you, later on it has been developed, that the investment in the economy should be such that the social marginal productivity, marginal mean here, addition made to the total production by investment of a new capital assets. When a new capital assets is more, and if the social marginal productivity is highest, then that type of criteria should be chosen. So this is called the SMP strategy, or investment in such a way that we have to create more and more social marginal capital. But remember that one important defect of this strategy is what? It is quite difficult to calculate the SMP. Social marginal capital cannot be calculated in a proper way. Anyway, that another group of people, this is a one-line theory. Another economist, group of economists, they viewed that capital turnover criterion, that is otherwise known as the capital output ratio. So you know that one economist, famous economist of our time, that is Professor J.J. Pollack, he viewed that balance of payment problem of a country. Here he discussed that the capital output ratio in any investment should be more. Capital output ratio means just one ton. Suppose you invest 1 unit of capital and the output is equal to 3. So here the capital output ratio equal to 3:1. That is 3:1. 3 capital is to 1, 3 output into and is to 1 unit of capital. So when the capital turnover, meaning whenever you are investing and the capital turnover is comparatively more, or we have to suggest, we have to invest in such and such project and plans where we can able to get higher incremental capital output ratio. Incremental capital output ratio means that the investment due to the change in the income or change in the output due to change in the investment. So if such a strategy is followed, that is another concept that will be given by Professor J.J. Pollack. But remember, every theory has its own defect or demerit. But mainly, we have to take into consideration the first one, that is the SMP or the capital output ratio. Either both the criteria can be used for the betterment of the society, or the production can be increased by utilizing any of the strategy. Then, when we go for, but one simple theory I want to tell you, and because our capital is low, maximum output should be generated from the investment of the rare or scarce resources. This is a very important concept of capital, that is investment criteria. Another famous economist, Nobel laureate economist, Professor A.K. Sen, Amartya Sen, he had given another type of concept that is known as the time series criterion. And according to this hypothesis, that the time horizon, means what type of impact the newly invested capital assets is creating over a period of time, then so suppose there are two, one second. So anyway, so there are two important type of investment. One is suppose investment two type of project. One is called the S, and other is called L. So S means this high capital intensive, and L means capital intensive, and L means labor intensive. Capital intensive means more capital is required and less labor is required, that is called capital intensive. And labor intensive means any type of technology where L is greater than the quantity of labor is more than your quantity of this capital. So in such, according to Professor Sen, he viewed that when the investment, the what we call this capital intensive technology tells you that how in the long run the particular project is going to benefit you. If the capital intensity is generated, more output in the long run, maybe less in the short period, in the long run, then the other type of technology, then we have to choose a capital intensive technology. So this is opportunity, let us say, suppose in a country like India, where there is an abundance of labor or a very high quantity of labor, we have to choose that type of technology where the employment generation is comparatively more and less capital is required and output is more. So what is the contribution? What are the contribution of this care capital, particularly over a long period of time? Over a long period of time, that is otherwise known as the time series criterion. But another very important question here arises. And what is that question? The question is, what type of technology we have to choose? What type of technology we are going to choose for our country? So normally, I told you that there are two types of technology. One is called the labor intensive technology, another is called the capital intensive technology. And this labor intensive technology means, there is otherwise known as LIT, labor intensive technology. Labor intensive technology tells you use of to produce a particular thing over a production possibility curve, when more quantity of labor is required and less of capital is required, that is known as labor intensive technique. And opportunely, the capital intensive technique tells you that more capital is necessary. Suppose using of a tractor by a farmer, so that is a capital intensive technology. But when the farmer is using, let's say, bullocks and plows and other, so that is otherwise known as use of more and more quantity of labor, that is known as your labor intensive technology. So we have normally two type of technology, and remember, both the technology has their own merits and demerits. For example, in a country like India, normally that we prefer a capital intensive a labor intensive technology because labor intensive technology can generate greater employment. But one important problem of labor intensive technology is that the process of production is comparatively slow. Or let's say in a modern technology world, somewhere you cannot make a steel plant with the help of labor. So if you go to a country like Japan, in Japan, normally they prefer a capital intensive technology because there is a shortage of labor, and that is comparatively a country having more capital rich country. So we have to choose both the technology, which technology is appropriate for your country. And another technology this modern economist, they are viewing that we have to go for a intermediate technology. Intermediate technology means there are some technology where in a country like India, for example, we have to choose both the technology, somewhere the capital intensive technology and somewhere the labor intensive technology. Whenever there is called an intermediate type of technology. So normally we have three important type of technology. One is capital intensive, another is labor intensive, and both the mixed type of technology, that is otherwise known as the intermediate technology. So we have to choose that which type of technology is suit for your country, because your resources is very, very scarce. Very, very scarce. So choosing this is a very important and the most important phenomenon for underdeveloped country. So anyway, this is a concept. This tells you investment criteria, that is the S&P or capital output ratio, or even what type of criteria to be followed. I'm just making a summary of the first unit, unit number 19, that what type of technology are to be followed. the first one, what type of investment is necessary, what criteria to be followed. Second one is what type of technology, whether a labor intensive or whether a capital intensive. So this is two important type of technology we have to follow. Then let us switch over to the next section of discussion. There is the cost benefit analysis. Cost benefit analysis. For example, this is a very top question or top concept of understanding. So cost benefit. Let me first explain with some simple words. Whenever you are taking a particular project, suppose construction of Hirakud Dam. Suppose you have decided to construct a dam. We have constructed the dam, Hirakud Dam. What is the cost of the project? And what are the benefit of the project? Okay. So cost means the expenses. It may be private cost or any other cost. Whenever the Hirakud Dam was constructed, we have seen a different type of cost. The construction cost one is. Another, the cost of displacement, the environmental pollution, or any other thing, whatever the expenditure bear by the society, that the social cost, and whatever the cost bear by you as a producer, that is your private cost. So that is known as the cost part. Another question is benefit part. What are the different type of benefit? What are the different types of benefit we are going to get from a particular project? Suppose from Hirakud Dam, what are the benefit and how long the benefit is going to help your country? For example, when we have constructed the Hirakud Dam, what are the benefit? So the objective of Hirakud Dam is what? For example, take the example of control of flood, one important question. Irrigation, digging of irrigation canal or in command area of the Balangir or the Sonpur and the Sambalpur part. That is another one. Electrification or the generation of electricity, that is another benefit. So cost means the expenses part, and benefit means what you are going to get from the particular project. So our topic of discussion is cost benefit analysis. So remember, when suppose you have decided a project and the cost of the project is more than the benefit, the cost of the project is more than the benefit you are going to get. মানে আমি যেতেবেলে কোনসি গোটে প্রজেক্ট হাতকু নেবা এবং সে প্রজেক্টর লাভ কিছু লাভ মিলিব দ্যাট ইজ কল দ্য বেনিফিট পার্ট এবং কিছু খরচ হব অর উই মে কল ইট দ্য নাম আমকো অন্য ভাষায় ক্ষতি বলে কোয়া যায় সাপোজ দ্য কস্ট অফ দ্য প্রজেক্ট কস্ট অফ দ্য প্রজেক্ট ইজ মোর দ্যান দ্য বেনিফিট বা আমার প্রজেক্টর লাভ পরিমাণ ক্ষতি ঠার কম হবে অর দি বেনিফিট ইজ লেস দেন দ্য কস্ট ইন সচ এ কেস উই হ্যাভ টু রিজেক্ট দ্য প্রজেক্ট অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ প্রজেক্ট হুইচ ক্যানট বি ইউজফুল অর উই ক্যানট রেকমেন্ড দ্যাট টাইপ অফ প্রজেক্ট সো রিমেম্বার সো কস্ট বেনিফিট ওয়েন এভার ইউ আর টেকিং এনি টাইপ অফ প্রজেক্ট ইউ হ্যাভ টু ক্যালকুলেট what are the different type of cost? Cost may be of your, it may be your private cost. Private cost means the cost in the form of raw material, cost in the form of labor, cost in the form of transportation, cost in the form of your, you take the example of the advertisement or any other thing, let's say. So this is the private cost. And remember, when a project is undertaken, we have to get some benefit too. We have to get some benefit too. And what the benefit we are going to get? That suppose a social cost question. Social cost means what the society is going to bear in the form of environmental degradation. Suppose a project is undertaken, then you have to cut the trees. Suppose a steel plant is installed, then we have to bear the consequences of your carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, or any type of environmental pollution, water pollution, sound pollution, health hazards. So these are certain expenses that you know as your social cost. So the total cost of the project is equal to the private cost as well as social cost. Another question, the benefit also goes to the private individual as well to the society. The private individual may get more and more profit, then it goes to the pocket of the private industrialist. And in the form of employment, in the form of creation of output, or for any other reason, the society also getting some benefit. So we have to compare the ratio between both the cost as well as the benefit. And the cost and benefit tells you whether a project is acceptable project or whether a project is not acceptable. So another question, whenever we are going for the cost and benefit ratio, that we have to take into consideration this thing like what is the gestation period of the gestation period. Remember, very, very, very important economic term. Gestation period means, suppose you have initiated a project today, you have started a project today, and after 2 years, you are going to get the production or product. So today you have invested, you will get the output after 2 years. So this two year period of time, that is known as the gestation period. So when the gestation, and I remember when you are a private industrialist, when the gestation period is very long, suppose the project is taking 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, the private individual is not interested in such type of project when the gestation period is comparatively very high. So my point of discussion is, we have to choose that project where there is a less gestation period. And remember, when we take the project, every project has its lifetime. So a lifetime in, for example, Hirakud Dam, it was constructed in 1956. And today, you know that it has covered almost all 60 years plus. So within this 60 year, how much of benefit it is going to give you? And another question, your depreciation. The time I know the Hirakud Dam era life, say somewhere aram or somewhere that is 100 years ago, how it was. Even gradually, Hirakud Dam era abastha gradually filtering, agri bali mati puti agri. Tar boyasa gradually kome kome avchi Hirakud Dam gradually khyati sambhavana ka kala niche. So question is that we have to take into consideration both the things. What is the time period? What type of depreciation is going to happen in the particular project? That is also very important. Anyway, so when we take into consideration, we have to check, we have to see the role of the government. So you know that today, neither the world is a capitalist country, nor the world is a socialistic country. Neither the world is a socialistic country, nor the world is a capitalist country. And today, it is a mixed country. In a mixed country, the government, in a mixed country, in a mixed economy, remember that we have to take into consideration both the things. Both the thing mean some important feature of the capitalist economy and some important feature of the socialist economy. So two type of thing we'll have to take into consideration. Here, for example, India, that it is a mixed type of economy. And here, even in America today or in China, the government is playing a vital role, a very, very important role. The government is playing a vital role, a very, very important role as a regulator, because the government framed the policy, for example, the industrial policy of India. The government framed the policy. In policy decision is normally taken by the government. Or for example, this LPG model, the liberalization, privatization, globalization model. That is the activities of the government. The government is a regulator. Sometimes the government also invest. The government also invest. The government is a producer. For example, in India, for example, your Rourkela plant, your NALCO, your Hindustan Aeronautics, or the Bhabha Atomic Research Center, or this DHEL. So these are certain activities which are performed by the government, railway, for example. So government is a regulator. Government is a health provider. Government will provide you basic amenities for production, like your construction of road, infrastructure building, your provision of dam. So government provides this. And government also impose taxes. So government, the role of the government as a authority which put restrictions on production, also encourage in the form of tax benefit, the government may encourage you also. So the government role is also primary thing while we are taking a decision related to our economic development. Then let me clarify the other part of our discussion. That is, in a country like India, again, I'm repeating till now, I shall go to the next last topic later on. We are a capital poor country. A proper investment criteria is required. The strategy may be balanced strategy. Balanced strategy means, माने जहाँ सब सेक्टर अच्छे प्राइमरी सेक्टर सेकेंडरी सेक्टर टर्शियरी सेक्टर सब सेक्टर में इन्वेस्ट अनदर स्ट्रेटेजी इज नॉट टू इन्वेस्ट इन ऑल द सेक्टर रादर इन्वेस्ट इन सर्टेन सिलेक्टेड सेक्टर ऑफ द इकोनॉमी वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू इन्वेस्ट इन ऑल द सेक्टर रादर सर्टेन सेक्टर व्हिच आर व्हाट वी कॉल द सिलेक्टेड सेक्टर ऑफ द इकोनॉमी. That is called the unbalanced growth strategy. Then we come to the investment criteria, in which field we have to invest. Then we have to choose the technology, which type of technology to be followed, the labor intensive or capital intensive. Then we come across another very important question, the role of the government. While deciding the cost and benefit ratio, the role of the government is also very important. The government is a driver. The government is a government provides of encouragement, incentive in the form of infrastructure building or any other thing. The government creates a variety of things for the society. Also, the government imposes taxes. The government gives you the license. The government will give you the SEZ, special economic zone. The government will give you the tax benefit scheme. Many things that the government has to. Now, the most another important part. So, I am just going to alluded to it. It is going to be a continuous process. So, continuity occurs. Next, what we are going to talk about is the planning. Planning. You understand this very, very, very funny chapter. I remember today we are in an era where we have to discuss and we have to analyze the role of the planning, the history of the planning. Let me come to the point, what is planning? And here our topic of discussion, the role of planning. So planning means simple thing. Fixation of some objective. And try to reach that objective within a given period of time. But simple example, cricket khelucho. So captain planning korchanta. Kon planning? How to win the game? Ko bowler bowling koriyo. କୋ ବ୍ୟାଟ୍ସମ୍ୟାନ୍କୁ କେମିତି ବୋଲିଂ କରିବ। ସିମିଲାରଲି ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ କୌଣସି ବାହାଘର କରୁଛୁ ଘରେ ଆମକୁ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କରିବା। ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଓଏସ୍ଓୟୁର କ୍ଲାସ୍ ଆଟେଣ୍ଡ କଲା ଆଜି ଆମକୁ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କରିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ ନାଇଁ ଆମକୁ 3:30 ଉଠିକରି କ୍ଲାସ୍କୁ ଜଏନ୍ କରିବାର ଅଛି ପ୍ଲାନିଂ। ଆମକୁ କୌଣସି ଜାଗାକୁ ଯିବାକୁ ହେଲେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କରିବ। ସୋ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ମିନ୍ସ ଫିକ୍ସେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସମ୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ରିଚ୍ ଦ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଏ ଗିଭେନ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। ଗୋଟେ ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ସମୟରେ ତାକୁ ପହଞ୍ଚିବାର କଲା ପ୍ଲାନ। ସୋ ହ୍ୱେନ୍ ୱି ଟକ୍ ଅବାଉଟ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ବଟ୍ ଆୱାର ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଅବାଉଟ୍ ୟୋର ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଫର୍ ପିକ୍ନିକ୍ ଅର୍ କୋଇ ମ୍ୟାରେଜ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଅର୍ ଏନି ଅଦର ପ୍ଲାନିଂ। ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଦ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଆମ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ଟେଲ୍ ୟୁ। ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ଟେଲ୍ ୟୁ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ପ୍ଲାନ୍। ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ସୋ ୟୁ ନୋ ୱାନ୍ ଫେମସ୍ ଇକୋନୋମିଷ୍ଟ ଆଇ ରିମେମ୍ବର ଡିକିସନ୍ ହି ଟୋଲ୍ଡ ଦଟ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଟେକିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଡିସିଜନ୍। ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଟେକିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଡିସିଜନ୍ ବାଏ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ ଅଥରିଟି। ଟେକିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଡିସିଜନ୍ ବାଏ କନ୍ସିୟସ୍ ଅଥରିଟି ଏବାଉଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ହାଉ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ହାଉ ମଚ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ୱେନ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ୱେର୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଏ ଗିଭେନ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। ମାନେ ଆମ ଉଦ୍ଦେଶ୍ୟରେ ଯେମିତି ଆମ ସମସ୍ତେ ଏଭ୍ରିବଡ଼ି ନୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏ ପଞ୍ଚବାର୍ଷିକ ଯୋଜନା ତା ଉପରେ ଆଲୋଚନା ହେବ। ପଞ୍ଚବାର୍ଷିକ ଯୋଜନା ହେଲା ଯେ ଆମ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି ଆରମ୍ଭ ହେଲା 1951 ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଫାଇଭ୍ ଇୟର୍ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ଆରମ୍ଭ ହୋଇଛି। ତାପରେ 2015 ମସିହା ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ଆମ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଚାଲିଲା। ତାପରେ ସରକାର ସେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କମିଶନକୁ ବନ୍ଦ କରିକିରି ଏବେ ଆଜିକାଲି ସବୁ ନୀତି ଆରମ୍ଭ କରିଦେଲେ 2015 January 1। ସୋ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ପଞ୍ଚବାର୍ଷିକ ଯୋଜନା, ପଞ୍ଚବାର୍ଷିକ ଯୋଜନା ଅର୍ଥ ହେଲା ଯେ ଆମେ ସରକାର ଗୋଟେ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ କଲୁ 1951 to 1956 ଭିତରେ ଆମେ ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଆମ କରିବାର ଅଛି। ସୋ ଦିସ୍ ଆର୍ ଦି ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ସ। ଏଇଟା ଆମ ଲକ୍ଷ୍ୟ ହେଲା ଏତିକି ରୋଡ଼ ତିଆରି କରିବୁ, ଏତିକି ଏଗ୍ରିକଲଚର ଇନଭେଷ୍ଟ ହେବ, ଏତିକି କଳକାରଖାନା ହେବ, ଏତିକି ରୋଡ଼ ଇନଫ୍ରାଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର ହେବ, ଏତିକି ସ୍କୁଲ କଲେଜ ହେବ। ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଫିକ୍ସେସନ୍। ସୋ ଏଭ୍ରି ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇନ୍ ଏଭ୍ରି ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ହେଦର ଇଜ୍ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଥାର୍ଡ ଅର୍ ଫୋର୍ଥ ଅର୍ ଇଭେନ୍ ଟିଲ୍ ଦି ଟ୍ୱେଲ୍ଥ ଫାଇଭ୍ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ହିଅର୍ ଦି ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଫିକ୍ସ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଫିକ୍ସିଂ ଦି ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ତାକୁ ପୂରଣ କରିବା। ତାକୁ ଗୋଟେ ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ସମୟ ଭିତରେ, ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ସମୟ ଭିତରେ ହେଲେ ଫାଇଭ୍ ଇୟର୍ ପ୍ଲାନ୍, କେଉଁ କେଉଁ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିରେ ବର୍ଷିକିଆ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ବି ଅଛି, କେଉଁ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିରେ 4-year ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ଅଛି, କେଉଁ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିରେ 3-year ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ଅଛି, ଲଙ୍ଗ ରନ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କେଉଁ କେଉଁ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିରେ 10-year ପ୍ଲାନ୍ ବି ଅଛି, ଯେ ଆମକୁ 5 ଭିତରେ ଏଇଟା ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ପୂରଣ କରିବାକୁ ହେବ। ଯେମିତି ଓଏସ୍ଓୟୁର ସ୍ଟୁଡେଣ୍ଟ ମାନେ ପରୀକ୍ଷା ଦେବେ ନା ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ କରୁଛୁ ନା ଏ ସେମିଷ୍ଟରରେ ଏ ଏ ପେପରକୁ କ୍ଲିଅର୍ କରିବେ, ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ। ସୋ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ସ, ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ମିନ୍ସ ଫିକ୍ସେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସମ୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ଏବାଉଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ହାଉ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ୱେନ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ୱାଟ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍ ହାଉ ମଚ୍ ଟୁ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସ୍। ସୋ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ମେକିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଗୋଲ୍ ୟୁ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ରିଚ୍ ଦ ଟାର୍ଗେଟ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଏ ଗିଭେନ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍। ସୋ ରିମେମ୍ବର ପ୍ଲାନିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପ୍ଲାନ୍ଡ ଇକୋନୋମି, ପ୍ଲାନ୍ଡ ଇକୋନୋମି ବିକଜ୍ ହିୟର୍ ୟୁ ହ୍ୟାଭ୍ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ୍ଡ ଆକ୍ସନ୍। ଆମକୁ ଏତିକି 5 କରିବାର ଅଛି, ସବୁ କାମ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷ କରିପାରିବା ନାହିଁ। 1000 ଡ୍ୟାମ୍ ତିଆରି କରିବାର ଅଛି ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷରେ ହେବ ନାହିଁ, ଅର୍ଜେଣ୍ଟ ବେସିସ୍ରେ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଟୁ କନଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଟ ଦ ଡ୍ୟାମ୍ ନା ଏଇଠି ଗୋଟେ ଡ୍ୟାମ୍ ଦରକାର ଅଛି ବା ଏ ରୋଡ଼୍ଟା ବେଶୀ ଦରକାର ଅଛି, ଏଜୁକେସନ୍ ସେକ୍ଟରରେ ପଇସା ଦରକାର ଅଛି। ଏବେ ଆମେ ଦେଖିଲା ଯେ ହେଲ୍ଥ ଇନଫ୍ରାଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର୍, ଏ କରୋନା ଆସିବା ଫଳରେ ପରେ ହେଲ୍ଥ ଇନଫ୍ରାଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର୍ ଆମ ଦେଶ କେତେ ଖରାପ ସ୍ଥିତିରେ ଥିଲା ସରକାରମାନେ ଅନୁଭବ କଲେ। ଏବଂ ଫର୍ ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଓଡ଼ିଶାରେ ଓଡ଼ିଶା ସରକାର ଗୋଟିଏ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲ ବି କରିବାର ଯେତେବେଳେ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ହେଉଥିଲା ତାଙ୍କୁ ପୁରା 30-30 କୋଭିଡ୍ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲ ତିଆରି କରିଥିଲେ, ଯେଉଁଠି ଗୋଟେ ସପ୍ତାହରେ ମାନେ 25-50 ଖାଲି ଟେଷ୍ଟ ହେଉଥିଲା, କରୋନା ଟେଷ୍ଟ ସକ୍ଷମ ଥିଲା। ଆଜି ଗୋଟେ ଦିନରେ 5000 ଟେଷ୍ଟ କରୁଛନ୍ତି। ସୋ ଦେଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲସୋ ଏ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ଲାନିଂ। ସୋ ଏନଦର ଦେୟାର ଆର୍ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ୍ ଟେକ୍ସନ୍ ୱିଦିନ୍ ଏ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍, ଦେନ୍ ଦି ଡିସିଜନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟେକେନ୍ ବାଏ a rational group of people. For example, in our country today, the Prime Minister is the chairman of the Niti Aayog. Before that, it was the planned economy, planning concept. Ko 2015 mo agar koi chhi bond karayala. Ebang Niti Aayog, ebe bhi jo Niti Aayog bhi jo decision hoche, je ko rajya re kete aavashyak hoche, je minister man chhi member hoibe. বিভিন্ন ইকোনমি উপরে যেমন নলেজ থিব দেবল বিদিন মেম্বর এন্ড এভরি পার্ট যেমন নলেজেবল লোক স্কোলার লোক এমানে সমস্তে রহবে তার মেম্বর রহবে এন্ড দে উইল টেক দ্য ডিসিজন হাউ টু অ্যাচিভ দ্য টার্গেট হাউ টু অ্যাচিভ দ্য টার্গেট উইদিন এ শর্ট পিরিয়ড অফ টাইম অর উইদিন এ গিভেন পিরিয়ড অফ টাইম এনিওয়ে সো প্ল্যানিং ইজ ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট এন্ড ইট ইজ এ সিম্বল অফ what we call the sovereignty of the country. And another question, economically, politically, socially, in every field, planning plays a very important role for the increasing national income, control of inflation, yeah, provision of more and more employment. For any other reason, planning plays a very important role. Without planning, we may not talk to, but however, because the plan failed, the government has changed the planning commission today to the Niti Aayog. Anyway, so planning concept, it's not only available in the socialistic form of society. Planning concept, you can see the concept of planning even in the capitalist society too. In a capitalist country like America, for example, why planning is necessary? You may raise your eyebrow whether planning what because the government is not taking any decision under a capitalist economy. What is the need of the planning? But for many purposes, there are certain activities which cannot be satisfied by the market. For example, the street light. Gute loko gute vyaktigato bhabare kounsi jagare street light logeibo nahi. ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଡ୍ରେନେଜ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ତୁମେ ଯେତେ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମ ଘରରେ ଘର ତିଆରି କରୁଛୁ ଘରୁ ଛୋଟ ଗୋଟେ ଡ୍ରେନ୍ ବାହାର କରୁଛୁ କିନ୍ତୁ ତାକୁ ମ୍ୟୁନିସିପାଲିଟି ଡ୍ରେନ୍ କରିକିରି ପାଣି ଆକୁ ନେଉଛି ସୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ସର୍ଟେନ୍ ସୋସିଆଲ୍ ଇନଫ୍ରାଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ଚର୍ ଅର୍ ହେଭି ଇନଭେଷ୍ଟମେଣ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ କେସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ରେଲୱେ କନଷ୍ଟ୍ରକ୍ସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ଡ୍ୟାମ୍ ୟୋର୍ ପ୍ରାଇଭେଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ କମ୍ଫର୍ଟେବଲ୍ ବିକଜ୍ ଦି ଗ୍ୟାସ୍ ଷ୍ଟେସନ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଲଙ୍ଗ୍ and the investment is more. So here, under a capitalist economy also, planning is necessary. And obviously, socialist economy is known as the planned economy here. The government takes the decision, the government takes the decision what to produce, how to produce, when to produce. All production decision is taken by the government. Similarly, in a mixed economy like India, planning is a mirror. Planning is a mirror. It gives you the reflection, what we can do, how much we can do, what is our target, whether we will be successful or whether we will not be successful. And it is the planning, there is like a light force that gives you a concrete direction. So this is what about the simple meaning of planning. When we talk about planning, let me, certain type of planning we can discuss here, certain planning like democratic planning. Democratic planning means when we involve people from all walk of life, that is otherwise known as the decentralized type of planning. The decision is not taken by a particular center. And ama deshara bikas kebala Delhi ba bikas kota agenda hebo seta Delhi kebala niye nahi. दिल्ली ठारू पल्ली पर्यंत फ्रॉम दिल्ली टू योर विलेज इवन इन पंचायत लेवल वी आर मेकिंग प्लानिंग इन ब्लॉक लेवल वी आर मेकिंग प्लानिंग इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल इन स्टेट लेवल एवरीवेयर वी आर मेकिंग द प्लानिंग एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड व्हेन द डिसीजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस इज गिवन टू ऑल सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी पार्टिसिपेशन फ्रॉम एवरी पार्ट ऑफ द सोसाइटी देन इज नोन एज डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड टाइप ऑफ प्लानिंग एंड हियर another type of planning you might have heard One is called the totalitarian or the dictator type of one. Dictator or totalitarian planning means opposite of democracy, dictatorship. माने गोटे देशर प्लानिंग कौटा हम कौन सब करदी सब जन गोटे निर्दिष्ट व्यक्ति एवं से लोक मान लदी दूर मान धर जो दिल्ली में केवल गोटे सरकार नरेन्द्र मोदी सरकार कहले ना यहाँ तुम मान आम मान कहार ओपिनियन ने ना से कहले ना एटा जिन तुम करने को बाध्य देट इज कल ए टोटालिटेरियन टाइप और ए डिक्टेटरशिप टाइप अफ प्लानिंग. So, both the planning has its merit or demerit, but normally we favor a democratic type of planning for an economy like India. But if you go to China, that there is a dictatorship type of planning, another type of planning. Planning by inducement. Mane lokomanku bujhei sujhei kiri ba lokomankara participation nei kiri jo planning hue, that is known as planning by inducement, or that is also a type of democratic planning. Another type of planning you will find, that the centralized planning, decentralized planning. As I told you earlier too, centralized planning means if all the decision is taken by a particular center, kendribhut, kendra sabu bale gote nirdishta decision je pele no pae taku centralized planning kaha jae. But से प्लानिंगटा जदि आम सबुटे भाग करदे फर एक्जाम्पल केवल दिल्ली डिसीजन नब ना से डिसीजन ओडिशा किंवा आम झारसुगुड़ा किंवा बरगढ़ किंवा संबलपुर किंवा आम मान निज ग्राम पंचायत मान जब से भितरे पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे देट इज कल डिसेंट्रलाइज टाइप देन एनदर कनसेप्ट विल फाइंड वन इज कल द indicative type of planning or imperative type of planning. Indicative type of planning means there is a small difference, that is in case of indicative planning it is concerned with essentially with indicating what is desirable. Indicate means suchana diye, a prakar planning humko suchana diye what is desirable with the expectation that the economy will confirm it. आमको कौन वास्तव में दरकार ताकू कह जाए तुम माना योर इंडिकेटिव प्लानिंग अन्य भाषा इंपेरेटिव प्लानिंग नॉट ओनली प्लान्स व्हाट इज डिजायरेबल बट एनश्योर दैट द इकोनॉमी सेफ्स इटसेल्फ एज पर प्लान रिक्वायरमेंट. इंपेरेटिव प्लानिंग रे कौन दरकार हुए केवल हुए ना रादर अर्थनीतिर भविष्य सेफ बा आकार बा तार निर्दिष्ट लक्ष्य किपर भाव ताकि सूचना दिए ताको इंपेरेटिव प्लानिंग बोली कह जाए. एनदर कनसेप्ट ऑफ प्लानिंग यू माइट हैव हर्ड वन इज कॉल्ड द माइक्रो लेवल प्लानिंग मैक्रो प्लानिंग एंड माइक्रो प्लानिंग. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द माइक्रो प्लानिंग इट कैरियर्स ऑन with the framework of the national plan in order to better meet the special need of a region. Micro level planning ro artha hala micro and macro, you know the difference between the two. Macro means the large and micro means the small. Gute nirdishta anchal re kono sabu avashyak achi taku nekri je tale planning kara hobo that is called micro level planning. For example बरगढ़ जिले में धान उत्पादन सब बेसी हुए तेणु बरगढ़ जिले में धान उत्पादन पर सरकार राइस मिल है कि कौन सी जिन कि सेलिंग सार जोगान सरकार जिते बेले पार्टिकुलरली बरगढ़ उपरे से चिंता करेंगे पर धर जो कलाहांडी धर जो कपा उत्पादन होने कपा कि उत्पादन हो कलाहांडी अलग डिसीजन हो बरगढ़ अलग डिसीजन ना झारसुगुड़ा बहुत गुड़े शिल्प अच्छे कलकारखाना अच्छे झारसुगुड़ा आम कि भाव में शिल्प कारखाना करवा इफ द डिसीजन इज टेकन इन सच ए वे दैट इज कॉल्ड माइक्रो लेवल प्लानिंग एंड इन केस ऑफ योर मैक्रो प्लानिंग दैट द डिसीजन इज टेकन फॉर द कंट्री एज ए होल देन प्लानिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज without a proper plan, the achievement of the target is not possible. Whether it's democratic planning, dictatorship planning, or micro planning, or the macro level planning, or imperative planning, or indicative planning. So whenever you are taking a decision, a proper planning model is very, very important. If you do not follow a model which is suit to your requirement, a model which suit to your requirement, your development is not possible. Again, I'm repeating the first point I told you in the beginning. In the beginning, I told you that we are a very, very capital poor country. And in a capital poor country, we have no right to destroy the capital or misutilize, underutilize, unutilize the capital. You have no right. So, ama pakre jahabi sampati achi. Taku, ba se sampati ko, if we use them in a proper way through the planning, automatically economic development is possible. Otherwise, development is not possible when there is no proper plan. So this is what about the planning. So this is a very easy chapter, and you might have discussed in your graduation level about the planning, fiber plan or any other plan, or this different type of model you have discussed. So I don't think it will be difficult for you, but it is just like an essay type of question. Now, we shall come to the another section of our discussion, that is international trade and development. International trade and development. So this is a very, very modern topic, update topic. So when we go for the trade, we have to discuss here international trade, whether it is gainful for the developing country or not, whether it is an engine of growth or whether it is a cost. Ame jetebele bedeshik banijya karuchu, you know, the trade means you have to export and import. And remember, when we export, ame jetebele roptani karu, when we export the goods and service to other country, we receive amku mile. On the other hand, when we import, ame jetebele baharu anuchu, we have to pay. So import means payment, that is debit minus, and export means that is receipt, that is loss. So our topic of discussion here is whether the trade is engine for growth or whether it is a cause for the underdevelopment. So remember, first question, many economists of our time, they viewed that trade is an engine of growth. International trade is an engine of growth because it the resources can be utilized in a better way. When there is a trade, then competition level will go up. The consumer will get the goods with a cheaper rate. More and more employment can be generated. More output can be created. And remember, we can able to break the vicious circle of poverty. Trade is an engine, and this engine can able to break the VCP, or vicious circle of poverty. So we view, we think, or the modern economist thinks, that trade is an engine of growth because it generates employment, enhances the market, extends the market. Output, capital, production, everything is comparatively more better. Technology will come to your economy. And that means trade is an engine of economic growth. But some very important group of economists, Purvis, Singer, and Medel, three important economists, Purvis, P-E-R-V-I-S-C-S, Singer, and Gunnar Medel, the view international trade is not an engine of growth. Gunnar Medel, you know, might have heard about his famous Nobel laureate economist. in his Asian drama, the famous book, or Pervis and Singer in their essay, they viewed that international trade is not beneficial for underdeveloped countries. Why international trade is not good for underdeveloped countries. So they have given certain reason. And bishesh kori amar jo mane bikashon mukhi desh India poriya dekho, normally we are exporting primary product mean mainly ame krushi jata drobya gura ko papa chawla gom masala coffee chapati ए सब जिन कि समुद्र मिंगुड़ी मंस मऊ ए सब जिन मान सब बाहर को एक्सपोर्ट कर एंड व्हेन वी एक्सपोर्ट द प्राइस ऑफ सच गुड्स इन द इंटरनेशनल मार्केट इज वेरी लेस इंटरनेशनल मार्केट रे प्राइस इज वेरी लेस एंड अगेन the demand for this product, the primary product, raw materials, rice, paddy, the demand is income inelastic. Mane aya modile bi loko mane beshi bhat khaibe nahi, aya modile they prefer some capital goods. On the other hand, the developed country export the capital goods to the underdeveloped country, because you know this one, America, Japan, Korea, China, England, France, Germany, because mukhe desh manko punji drabya export, jodi for example fighter plane, super computer, finished product, e sabu jinish gura pa mane अंडर डेवलप कंट्री को एक्सपोर्ट एवं तां से जिनिस जोड़ा एक्सपोर्ट करते ताकत वैल्यू इज कंपैरेटिवली वेरी हाई से सब जिनिस मूल्य कंपैरेटिवली वेरी तो दुटा जिनिस अंडर डेवलप कंट्री सब बेले जो जिनिस माने एक्सपोर्ट करे तार टर्म ऑफ ट्रेड द रेट एट व्हिच द गुड्स आर एक्सचेंज इन टर्म ऑफ अदर गुड्स देन द टर्म ऑफ ट्रेड and this is not favorable to other development because some mukhya desh mane bishesh kore ethu konsi prakar faida paanti nahi ebong jehetu ame sabu bod bod machine pati kinuchu anya man ko kintu ame jo jinish bikri korchu under developed country ko jara developed country ko tar market value bahut kam telo perbi singer medal से माने कहते आम सब आमको हुशियार होमको जितने डेवलप कंट्री मान सहित ट्रेड करमको हुशियार हो पड़ बिकज इन द लॉन्ग रन वी विल पेरिश सो दिस इज द टाइप ऑफ ओपिनियन ऑपोजिट टाइप ऑफ ओपिनियन गिवन बाय पेरवी सिंगर एंड मिडल देन व्हेन वी गो फॉर द another part of analysis we shall discuss about something about the balance of payment situation. So remember this is another very important topic for your examination point of view, very, very, very important. So balance of payment, as I told you just in the beginning, the balance of payment is the systematic records. Balance of payment is the systematic records of all international transaction. Balance of payment is the systematic record of all international transaction during a particular period of time. Mane gote barsha bhitre gote nirdishta desha kon kon sabu jinisa anya desaru anichi अन्य देश रु आनी पैसा पेमेंट एवं को जिनिस अन्य देश को बिक्री कर एक्सपोर्ट मीन पैसा पाई ताको जितेबाला आम गोटे सिस्टमेटिकली बोथ द विजिबल एज वेल एज इनविजिबल ଭିଜିବୁଲ ଆଇଟମ୍ ଏବଂ ଇନଭିଜିବୁଲ ଆଇଟମ୍ ଉଭୟକୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ରେକର୍ଡ କରୁ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ସିଟ୍ ବ୍ୟାଙ୍କରେ ଯେମିତି ବାଲାନ୍ସ ସିଟ୍ ବୋଲାଯାଏ ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ସିଟ୍ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ରେକର୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ବୋଥ୍ ଦିସ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମେଟିକ୍ ରେକର୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ବୋଥ୍ ଦି ଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଆଜ୍ ୱେଲ୍ ଆଜ୍ ଇନଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଆଇଟମ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅନଦର୍ ୱାର୍ଡ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ମିନ୍ସ ୱାନ୍ ୱି ରେକର୍ଡ ଓନ୍ଲି ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଏକ୍ସପୋର୍ଟ ହ୍ୱିଚ୍ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ବି ରେକର୍ଡେଡ୍ ଆଟ୍ ଦ ପୋର୍ଟ ମାନେ ଯାହା ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ପୋର୍ଟରେ ରେକର୍ଡ କରାଯାଇପାରେ ଯେମିତି କୋଇଲା ଆଟକିଗଲା କମ୍ପ୍ୟୁଟର କି କିଣିଲା ଫ୍ୟାକ୍ଟର ପ୍ଲେନ୍ ଏତେ ଆସିଲା ଯେଉଁଟା ଆମେ ପୋର୍ଟରେ ଆମେ ରେକର୍ଡ କରିପାରିବା ତାକୁ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ କରନ୍ତି ଆଉ ଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ପ୍ଲସ୍ ଇନଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଇନଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଅର୍ଥ ହେଲା ସର୍ଭିସେସ୍ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ପ୍ରକାର ସର୍ଭିସ୍ ଯାହାକୁ ରେକର୍ଡ କରାଯାଇପାରେ ନାହିଁ କିନ୍ତୁ ଦେଟ୍ ଗିଭ୍ ରାଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ମନିଟାରୀ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ଜାକ୍ସନ୍ ହୁଏ ତାକୁ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ କରନ୍ତି ସୋ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମର ତିଆରି କରାହୁଏ ୱେନ୍ ଏଭର୍ ୱି ମେକ୍ ଇଟ୍ ତା ଦୁଇଟି ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ କରାହୁଏ ଗୋଟେ କୁହାଯାଏ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ ଦି ଅଦର୍ ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ ଦି କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ଇନ୍ ଦ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହିୟର୍ ୱି ଟେକ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ କନ୍ସିଡରେସନ୍ ଦ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ଜାକ୍ସନ୍ ଦାଟ୍ ହ୍ୟାପେନ୍ସ ଡ୍ୟୁରିଂ ଦି ପାର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ଇୟର୍ ସର୍ଟ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ସର୍ଟ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ ବା ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷରେ କ'ଣ ସବୁ ଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇନଭିଜିବୁଲ୍ ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷ ଭିତରେ ୱାନ୍ ଇୟର୍ କ'ଣ ସବୁ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ଜାକ୍ସନ୍ ହେଲା ଇଫ୍ ୱି ଟେକ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ କନ୍ସିଡରେସନ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନୋନ୍ ଏଜ୍ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟ ଆଉ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ସଫର୍ ଦ ମନି ଲୋନ୍ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଗୋଲ୍ଡ ଯାହାକି ଲୋନ୍ ଆଣିବା ଅନ୍ୟ ଦେଶରୁ ଲୋନ୍ ଆଣିଲେ ସେଟା ବର୍ଷେରୁ ବେଶୀ ଯାଏ ସୁଧ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ କରିବା ସୁନା ବା ଋଣ ଗ୍ରହଣ କରିବା ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷକୁ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ରଖାହୁଏ ଏବଂ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ଯେଉଁ ଟ୍ରାନ୍ଜାକ୍ସନ୍ ମାର୍କେଣ୍ଡିଜ୍ ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷ ଭିତରେ ହୁଏ ତାକୁ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ରଖାହୁଏ ଏବଂ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ଯଦି ଡେଫିସିଟ୍ ହେଇଗଲା ତାକୁ କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ସରପ୍ଲସ୍ କରାହୁଏ ଏବଂ ଦିନ ଉଦାହରଣ ସ୍ୱରୂପ କରେଣ୍ଟ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ମାଇନସ୍ ହଜାରେ ଟଙ୍କା ହେଲା କ୍ୟାପିଟାଲ୍ ଆକାଉଣ୍ଟରେ ପ୍ଲସ୍ ହଜାରେ ଟଙ୍କା ହେବ ମାଇନସ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଥାଉଜେଣ୍ଡ ପ୍ଲସ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଥାଉଜେଣ୍ଡ ମିଶିକିରି ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟକୁ ଜିରୋ କରାହେବ ମିନ୍ ରିସିପ୍ଟ ସାଇଡ୍ ଆଉ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ସାଇଡ୍ ଉଭୟ ସମାନ ହେଇଥିବା କଥା ଆଣ୍ଡ ଇନ୍ ଏ ଅଣ୍ଡର୍ ଡେଭଲପ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରି ଲାଇକ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଦି ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ୍ ନେଗେଟିଭ୍ ଦେଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡେଫିସିଟ୍ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ୱି ଆର୍ ଫେସିଂ ଇଟ୍ ମିନ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଏକ୍ସପୋର୍ଟିଂ ଲେସ୍ ବଟ୍ ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟିଂ ମୋର୍ ମିନ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ରିସିଭିଂ ଲେସ୍ ଆମେ ଉଦାହରଣ ସ୍ୱରୂପ ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ବର୍ଷରେ ଦଶ ଲକ୍ଷ କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା ଏକ୍ସପୋର୍ଟ କଲାବେଳେ ପନ୍ଦର ଲକ୍ଷ କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା ଇମ୍ପୋର୍ଟ କରୁଛୁ ମାନେ ଦଶ ଲକ୍ଷ ଆମର ପ୍ଲସ୍ ହେଉଛି ପନ୍ଦର ଲକ୍ଷ ମାଇନସ୍ ହେଉଛି ଅତ ତାର ବାଲାନ୍ସ ହେଲା ପାଞ୍ଚ ମାଇନସ୍ ଫାଇଭ୍ ଥାଉଜେଣ୍ଡ କ୍ରୋର୍ସ ଅଲମୋଷ୍ଟ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ଅଣ୍ଡର୍ ଡେଭଲପ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରି ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ନଟ୍ ଟକିଂ ଓନ୍ଲି ଅବାଉଟ୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିଆ ଅଲମୋଷ୍ଟ ଅଲ୍ ଦି ଅଣ୍ଡର୍ ଡେଭଲପ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ଆର୍ ଫେସିଂ ଏ ଡେଫିସିଟ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଆଉ ସେ ଡେଫିସିଟ୍ ଯେଉଁ ହେଇଯିବ ସେ ରୋଗ ଭଳିଆ ଆମକୁ ପୁଣି ଋଣ ଆଣିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ ଧର ଯେଉଁ ମାଇନସ୍ ପାଞ୍ଚ ଲକ୍ଷ କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା ହେଇଗଲା ସେ ପାଞ୍ଚ ଲକ୍ଷ ଟଙ୍କା କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା ପାଇଁ ଆମକୁ ପୁଣି ମାଥାମାରି କରିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ ୱାର୍ଲ୍ଡ ବ୍ୟାଙ୍କ IMF ଅର୍ ବିଭିନ୍ନ ସଂସ୍ଥାକୁ ଯାଇକିରି ତାକୁ ହାତ ପାତିବାକୁ ପଡ଼ିବ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଟେକିଂ ଦେୟାର ମନି ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଆମ ଋଣ ଭାର ଧୀରେ 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 ବଢ଼ି ବଢ଼ି ଯାଉଛି ସୋ ବାଲାନ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟଟା ଯେତେବେଳେ ନେଗେଟିଭ ଥାଏ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲୱେଜ୍ ଏ ଡେଞ୍ଜର ସିଗ୍ନାଲ୍ ଫର୍ ଦି ଗ୍ରୋଥ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଇକନମି ଗୋଟେ ଦେଶର ବିକାଶ ପାଇଁ ସବୁବେଳେ ଗୋଟେ ଡେଞ୍ଜର ସିଗ୍ନାଲ୍ ବୋଲି ଆମେ ତାକୁ କହିପାରିବୁ ଦେନ୍ ନାଓ ୱି ଶାଲ୍ କମ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଦି ଲାଷ୍ଟ ସମରୀ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦି ଡିସ୍କସନ୍ ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦି ଇଣ୍ଟରନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଇଣ୍ଟରନ୍ୟାସନାଲ୍ ଇକୋନୋମିକ୍ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଦ ଗାଟ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଡବ୍ଲ୍ୟୁଟିଓ ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଟାଇପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ୱି ଆର୍ ଫେସିଂ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଦି ଗାଟ୍ ଏଣ୍ଡ ଦ ଡବ୍ଲ୍ୟୁଟିଓ GATT, you might have heard this very popular name, that is General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. This is one important organization that was established under the leadership of United Kingdom and USA in 1947. In 1947, the General Agreement on Trade and Tariff, and there was a agreement among the nation. जो जो माना one line, उटे line में बुझी जाओ, माना आमा जो जो country माना सब trade कर चंते, जो जो country माना सब आमा trade कर चंते, समस्त मिसी के लिए उटे agreement, जब आमे how to there should not be any sort of exploitation. कौनसी प्रकार exploitation जेपरे न हो, तेरे उटे agreement कराई थला, ताको कहा जाए get agreement. एवं से get agreement आ, get आ मैंने that is very partial and that is just like the puppet in the hand of US. अमेरिका तेरे उटे puppet हो लिया थला. अमेरिका जहाँ कोई भी सेमाने से हिसाब रे कोई भी, they will dance according to the tune of America, and after that the GATT was rejected. A new concept was established that is known as WTO, the World Trade Organization. The World Trade Organization after the Uruguay round of talk, Uruguay re gote baithak basila, ebong 1995 re January 1 tarikh re gote nua sangathan पृथ्वी सृष्टि आ से संगठन है दैट इज वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एम जो वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अच्छे से वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन तार उद्देश्य पर लक्ष्य है जे डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ट्रेड इन द वर्ल्ड पृथ्वी वाणिज्य विकास किपर भाव छोट छोट देश मैंने विशेषकर विकासोन्मुखी देश मैंने इंडिया भाया देश मैंने exploit noebe ba shoshit noebe and that was the main agenda the particular WTO was established and till now after we are also a member of WTO World Trade Organization tar artho konosi desaro jinso jete bele amo desh ko asibo amme ताको एक्सेसिव टेरिफ टेरिफ मीन टैक्स ऑन एक्सपोर्ट एंड इंपोर्ट एक्सेसिव टेरिफ देकर ताको हमें हैरान करी परबा नहीं वन पार्ट सेकंड क्वेश्चन होला जे हमको अनफेयर मींस ऑफ ट्रेड हो नहीं माने फॉर एग्जांपल अमेरिका और एनी अदर कंट्री तो जो माने बहुत बड़ बड़ देश नॉर्मली दे आर ट्राइंग टू इन्फ्लुएंस द डेवलप अंडर डेवलप कंट्री ताको की परिभावरे प्रतिहित करा जीवो छोर छोर राष्ट्रों में की परिभावरे सहजोग बा ट्रेड रे शामिल है परिवे सो दैट इज अ मेकैनिज्म दैट वाज डेवलप्ड बाय डब्ल्यूटीओ एंड दे मेड अ वैरायटीज ऑफ ट्रेड रिफॉर्म ट्रेड रे बहुत गुडे रिफॉर्म आनी छे डब्ल्यूटीओ एंड डब्ल्यूटीओ इज टुडे वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इट इज वर्किंग बट हाउएवर इट इज आल्सो फेसिंग सम टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज़ like the WTO or the World Bank or IMF, most of the time they are interested to keep the self of the developed country. माने विशेष करे जो माने developed country, विकसित देश माने अच्छा से विकसित देश मान को स्वार्थ को जोगिबा पाए, ये माने विशेष करे काम करे. And today we are in the world, what is called the globalization world. The world is free today. All the doors and windows are open. Doors and windows are open today, and it's because the doors and windows are open, we are bound to welcome other country goods from other country, investment from other country, foreign direct investment, foreign institutional investment. We are living in such a world, and it is a great merits. Market will be extended. Employment can be generated. Your people can get employment. Many things can be happen when there is a globalization. But there is a problem when there is a globalization. The big country, big companies, they will enter your country, and you cannot be self-reliant. छोट-छोट देशों में globalization प्रवृत्ति समरे तांकर विकास डेवलपमेंट इज नॉट पॉसिबल स्पेसिफिकली फॉर द अंडर डेवलपमेंट अविकसित राष्ट्र मैंने विकास कौन प्रकार विकास सामिल हो पार ना बिकज ऑफ द इंटरफियरेंस बाय दिस बिग पावर बिग इकोनॉमिक पावर और सुपर पावर सो दिस आर सर्टेन टॉपिक वेयर वी नीड ए मोर मोर एंड मोर डिस्कशन एंड द क्वेश्चन ऑफ डिस्कशन इज दैट रिसोर्सेस मस्ट बी यूटिलाइज इन द बेस्ट वे सेल्फ रिलायंस इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आफ्टर दिस कोविड वर्ल्ड वी हैव सीन आवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर इज ऑल्सो टेलिंग अबाउट सेल्फ रिलायंस आम निज गोड़ आमको किसी परिमाण आमको ठिया हाँ हम एंड अत्यधिक परिमाण में फॉरेन कंट्री बा वैदेशिक मानक साधारण छोट छोट जिन एनकरेज करवा देश क्षतिकर और दैट विल बी ए हार्मफुल थिंग फॉर द इकोनॉमी ए प्रकार किसी आम टॉपिक ये नहीं पार एंड दिस इज नॉट ओनली फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू दिस इज ए टॉपिक और दिस इज ए प्रॉब्लम व्हेयर यू विल फाइंड ए वैरायटीज ऑफ न्यू होराइजन न्यू होराइजन न्यू थिंग्स न्यू थिंकिंग विल कम टू योर माइंड about the strategy of development, about the balanced growth, about the unbalanced growth, about the world order, about the concept of planning, about the strategy of planning, about the GATT, role of WTO, or any other thing, then a variety of things that come to our mind when we talk about this block 6. And it is a very, very important block, not only for your examination point of view, but this will enhance your general knowledge. Okay, so this my student, any query or anything else? Dr. Ashish?
Yes, sir. There are some questions.
Yeah.
One was there, which I have clarified already. The difference between...
please repeat. I am unable to listen. Please repeat.
Is it audible? One question is asked here. What is the difference between the steady state and the balanced growth?
So there is a so if we'll return back to the concept in a steady state growth. So first you understand the balanced growth and steady state. Balanced growth means this simultaneous investment in all the sectors of the economy during a particular period of time. A steady state growth rate means the investment in a particular or selected sector of the economy and what we call the growth rate to achievement of the growth rate with a particular 6-7 or 8 or something else. So this type of strategy is known as a steady state strategy. But practically, in the underdeveloped country, expectation of a steady state of growth is not possible. As in the Hirschman, he told that the investment in SOC, social overhead capital, and directly productivity activity, if a proper and simultaneous investment is made, either in the DPA or in the SOC, then there will be some disequilibrium, and disequilibrium leads to equilibrium. So there is that type of difference you can find.
So basically, in a steady state, that represents long-run equilibrium of the economy, where the key economic variables are not changing. And you can see economy at steady state will always stay there. On the other hand, economy that are not in a steady state will try to approach there. So this is what I have clarified then. The second question is there. Viswaranjan Mishra. Now a date Niti Aayog is planning for how many years? Yeah, Niti Aayog was basically created in 1st January 2015. Now he is also asking, is it same for 5 years as earlier as 5-year plans. I'm not getting. Is it same for 5 years as early? No. NITI Aayog doesn't have 5-year planning now. They are having 7 years goal, 15 years goal, etc. Am I right?
So they are making a target for a particular period of time.
They are also little broadened. They are helping the, that is a think tank which is helping not only the central government but also the state government as well as the corporate firms in investment decisions. So it's a broader concept in helping India in the growth path. Now there is another question here. In India, BOP will be prepared in which currency? Because we export to different countries and also import from different countries. So how to record it and at what rate of exchange it will be recorded? So it's basically asking this balance of payment, how it is recorded, in which currency, and then because it is with multiple countries, which currency will be using to record it?
So normally, you know that in our country we are using that the balance of payment in term of your home currency, that we have to accept. For example, in India we have to keep record in term of our rupees. In term of rupees, we will have to record. Suppose we are getting some yen or any dollar or any other thing, that we have to convert it in term of our own currency, and accordingly we have to record, we have to keep record as per our own currency.
Is that clear? It is recorded in Indian currency, of course. You can convert at any point of time to some other currency using the exchange rate whenever it is required, but basically the records are in Indian currency.
Definitely.
So the next question is, what is shadow price?
So look at, there is a very interesting funny term. I'm just first clarify you in Odia, then we'll go English. But the genius could have project over. Actually, I'm a tar exact price term to Jordan. Put a social project, for example, the Hirakud Dam or any other one, or NH construction, or any other plan or project we have taken. So Amku put on money, put a record, you may call it exact wording to say. The on money is a recovery at an empty actually. I'm a Hebar Kota. So this month should be, it's one thing. So we have to keep the estimate price. Shadow price is the estimated price of a goods or service for which there is no market price exist. So it is a price, mana jo jenis ra market price nahi or market price is not available, tar gode estimated price ko shadow price bole kahe. Amar एत्ती है बार कथा हम सोलपुरी भाषा रे एत्ती गुटे तार गो रफ एनालिसिस को हम सेट ऑफ प्राइस करू एक्चुअली तार मार्केट प्राइस नता डॉक्टर आशीष को क्लारिफाई
या सेट ऑफ प्राइस यू राइटली मेंशन सी व्हेन वी आर लुकिंग एट आवर कंप्यूटिंग द नेशनल इनकम एटसेट्रा वी यूज मेनी मेथड्स इंप्यूटेशन कंप्यूटेशंस प्रोजेक्शंस estimations. So at times when we don't have this actual price of a goods which is not market determined, for example, you are occupying your own house, you have to impute certain price because you are occupying the own house. So in that locality, what is the price there? So for similar house, we can impute that value, which is a shadow of it. So shadow pricing is like that. Now one more concept is there, imperative planning.
So look at in contrast with socialistic type of planning, it is essentially a planning by direction. सोशलिस्टिक प्लानिंग इज ए प्लानिंग बाय डायरेक्शन और कमांड फॉर एग्जांपल चाइना चाइना रे ताकर से कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी जोटा जोटा डिसीजन नबो बा अगुर जोटे जें जार सरकार थिला बा अन्य माने सेटे गुटे डिक्टेटरशिप टाइप ऑफ गुटे जें डिसीजन थिला तार देयर इज अनदर टाइप ऑफ प्लानिंग ए सोशलिस्टिक प्लानिंग यू नो दैट A socialistic planning is then called imperative planning as the central planning authority platform. Central planning authority platform. All economic activities in the best interest of the society. When the central planning authority platform, all activities, central planning authority platform, all economic activities that is called imperative planning central planning se mane they are taking the decision about all these thing
is it clear then one more question is there I don't think it can be answered because it is too big itself it needs another session AK sense contribution to economic growth
So for one mana line I want to tell you that is a Nobel laureate okay Nobel laureate and I think that his contribution is the concept of many things they have called like mana model of growth or you take the labor intensive capital intensive type of planning the role of the government Many things you cannot, as you told that Akesan contribution, as such he got the Nobel Prize, and you cannot quote within half an 1 minute what is his contribution. But he is only one man whom, for whom we proud. Akesan, Ajit Pardanto, Amar Gupta, Loko, Jeki, जहाँ पाएं हमको किसी गर्व international level पे किसी गर्व कर सुजोग मिली बोली इकोनोमी को बेसिकली हिज कंट्रीब्यूशन इज जस्ट फाउंडलेस
वन मोर इज देयर टुडे दे आर बाई वेरी वेरी एक्टिव
हाँ ना वेरी एक्टिव थे ना
यूनिडो अप्रोच एंड एलएम मॉडल ऑफ कॉस्ट बेनिफिट एनालिसिस
या
UNITO UNIDO approach and LM model of cost benefit analysis
so one thing that this UNIDO approach measures the cost and benefit in term of consumption mana UNIDO approach approaches the cost of benefit in term of consumption whereas the LM model measures the cost and benefit in term of uncommitted social income for good example goche आम गोटे जो गोटे प्लान करुचु से हाउ मच ऑफ बेनिफिट दैट द कॉस्ट एंड हाउ मच ऑफ बेनिफिट वी आर गेटिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ कंजम्पशन हिसाब से आमको बेनिफिट होते लॉस होती यूनिडो अप्रोच बोली कह जाए एंड वर एज एल एम मॉडल अप्रोच मेजर द कॉस्ट एंड बेनिफिट इन टर्म ऑफ अनकमिटेड सोशल इनकम अनकमिटेड सोशल इनकम मीन दैट इनकम with the society or something else we have not committed ekhi hebo bole amar commitment nai kintu gude jinis hei pare the unity approach focus on efficiency efficiency saving and redistribution aspect of the different part of the society mana gote approach consumption ko kouchi a gote approach social income ko ta kouchi mana take the example of कौन से गोटे प्रोजेक्ट जो निजाए व्हाट इज दि बेनिफिट दि सोसाइटी इज गोइंग टू गेट ऑफ दि पर्टिकुलर प्रोजेक्ट और व्हाट इज दि लॉस फॉर एग्जांपल एनवायरमेंटल पोल्यूशन और एनी अदर थिंग देट दि नेगेटिव नेगेटिव एक्सटर्नालिटी आमको एम्प्लॉयमेंट जेनेट है आमर के इनकम बढ़ुचे स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लिविंग बढ़ुचे जोटा से कमिट करना ये हे बोले कही ना But LM model tells you that part. I think you are clear. this problem.
Which type your answer? Is it clear? Sir, if you permit, can I ask one question?
Yes.
Very simple one, but for the benefit of the students. Can we say that more equitable society grow faster?
So there is a long debate related to your question. Definitely, economy or the principle of economies or the micro or macro or any other thing, you see that when there is a equal distribution of income, the social welfare is comparatively more. But in terms of growth, you cannot say like this. Because if all income will be distributed properly, the propensity to consume of the poor man will be more. But propensity to save is less. Saving is very important, and that is made by the rich. That is made by the rich. So the question is, as a student of economics, I feel an equal type of society provide greater welfare. That much I can say, and greater welfare. And with respect to growth, that depends upon how much efficient your mechanism is.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
If there is any more questions, it is fine. Otherwise, we shall formally close this session. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
I don't think any more question is there. And you have clarified, not only given an excellent session on very vital topic, development strategy. Though we were aware earlier about the growth models, the strategy is also equally essential in terms of understanding what kind of investment, whether it should be labor intensive, capital incentive intensive, or what kind of cost benefit analysis are there, how to evaluate a project, and what kind of strategy the economists or the planners should follow so that we can take the economy to a equilibrium path, growth path. That is the key concern of our macroeconomic policy, how to ensure economic growth along with price stability and employment. So thank you for this session. I am sure our learners would have got enormously benefited from this session, and I would like to thank for your patience, answers that you have given to all the queries. Though we have exceeded time, it is only for the benefit of the students.
Thank you everyone. Thank you, my dear friends. Okay, let us enjoy the economy.
Thank you,
everybody.
Thank you.